We have a Dell Latitude E7240 and it doesn't turn on. Let's attempt to fix it. I've removed the back cover already and removed the battery and the RAM and the SSD just to rule out any of those components, and it's still not turning on. With the multimeter, I can see 19 volts is coming through, so a charger and the DC jack is good. Time to disassemble the whole laptop. And by the way, this is one of the worst design of laptops. To get into motherboard, you even have to remove the LCD display. It's a lot of work, so enjoy the video. Thank you. Now I've plugged in a power supply, which is coming from a variable power supply controller, and I can see how many amps is being pulled out. Now, something's very interesting about this power button. It's sort of playing up. It's sometimes working, sometimes not. So that's what I decided to focus on primarily. As you can see, the on button LED is coming on without me pressing it. And when I'm pressing the button, it's neither turning off or turning on. So I'm going to get the multimeter to do a test, see if the power button's actually working or not. And I've tried with the multimeter and I couldn't find the positive and the negative and could not find or determine if the button was working. After removing the button, I actually figured out why not. I was putting the probes in the wrong pins. The laptop all of a sudden did turn on by itself, as you can see here, without me doing anything. And when it's turned back on, I tried to power off the system using the power button, and it just wouldn't turn off. So that indicated to me the power button is actually not working. Let's go ahead and remove this power button and put another one in. Here is our power button. So just before removing, with the multimeter, I found out which one is negative and positive. So you make sure you know which one is which. Now with tweezers, I'm just going to short the pins manually, turn the computer on and off, and you can see that the problem was the button. Here is the metal button I pulled out of a Toshiba laptop, and it's slightly bigger, but we'll manage to fit it in. And important to get the orientation right. So here we go. It's not the best job in the world, but it fixed the problem. Thank you. Now let's test the new button. Sweet, that's working good. Now let's put it all back together. The replacement power button I used is from another laptop, a Toshiba laptop, and it's got a metal casing around it, and with that too I also measured where the negative and the positive are, and I'll put it into this new board in the right orientation. Now the new button is actually slightly taller, so the on button from the casing has a small plastic bit, so I need to trim it down a little bit so that it presses at the right amount when you push the button in. So I just keep adjusting until I feel it's perfect and the button is fitting in nicely. Thank you. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.